So it seems that I might have actually cracked the code really long ago when it came to the original fight for Core 2 of the Bleach Thousand Year Blood War arc. And what a trailer we got, and we are going to deep dive into it. But I specifically, this video, would like to talk about that original fight because not all is actually what it seems. And this might actually blow your mind on what the original fight actually is and why I'm cracked. So join me as I give a prediction, a very strong prediction about what this original fight is, as well as what other characters are going to be doing. So sit down and enjoy and let your favourite Bleach YouTuber talk about this. And if I'm not your favourite, I'm going to be very shortly. Maybe, possibly. Hit that subscribe and like. Let's get into it, shall we? So of January this year, 2023, I speculated that the original fight was going to have something to do with Shinji and something to do with either the Bambis or Lilotto. This was based off process of elimination. Now, of course, I was going to do a Core 2 trailer, breakdown and analysis, and I was just kind of rent-free about what Iba was doing within that trailer and what Momo was actually doing as well. And as I was scouting through this trailer and figuring out who Iba was actually fighting, whose sword that was, and going through each and every single one of the Stern Ritters and breaking it down of who this person could be, I figured out that most of the Stern Ritters are busy and most of them don't even use swords in the first place. So I looked at the characteristics of who uses that kind of sword, because it wasn't Bambietta, because Bambietta's is kind of like an Arabian type esque sword, and like there's energy swords, and that sword in particular didn't look like it belonged to anyone. So I was like, okay, well, what are they wearing? They're wearing a collared up kind of like quinta gear, and basically all the Stern Ritters do wear collared up like outfits. And I was like, well, wait, does the Soldats also wear their uniform with the collar up? And they do. And it seems like Iba is fighting a bunch of Soldats. Okay, we've moved somewhere forward. And Momo, does she fight pretty much anywhere within this arc as well? Well, she gets kind of clotheslined by Komamura when she's about to attack Bambi, or Bambi's about to attack her. So, no, she's not fighting anyone either. Okay, well, let's have a look at Shinji. What's Shinji doing? And of course, we see him in the trailer. He's fighting a bunch of Soldats after there's a bunch of Soul Reapers on the floor. And I'm like, surely, I mean, obviously that's the purpose of Shinji's Bankai. If you guys haven't read the light novels, you know, Shinji's Bankai basically lets the enemies turn on each other. So it can't be used in a 1v1 fight. And this is very important. It cannot be really, it's not really, I mean, we don't know per se, but it's not really used in a one-on-one battle. And that's the key element to all of this. It can't be used in a one-on-one battle. So you're telling me Shinji's just going to be fighting a bunch of Soldats? That's where he's going to flex his Bankai? It's quite funny that in the trailer too, that in comparison to the manga, Shinji and Komamura are there fighting Bambietta, and Shinji obviously gets damaged by Bambietta. Obviously he gets blown up, the explode on his chest, ba-boom, right? He's on the floor. We see him on the floor in some Komamura scenes. Interestingly enough, the buildings are damaged in the PV with Shinji versus the Soldats, and Shinji is unharmed. Very interesting detail there as well. So, who is Shinji fighting? Well, of course he's fighting the Soldats, but who's he going to be fighting afterwards? Who's literally in the same panels as Shinji's chapter in that fight? The Bambis. It's the fucking Bambis. And not a living soul on Twitter or on YouTube has mentioned this. Because everyone's so caught up in Shinji's Bankai that they're forgetting that Kubo wanted to implement the Bambis more. He said in the first interview that he had before the anime came out, if you remember the one from Anime Expo, the first ever interview that Kubo gave for the English audience, he said he wanted to incorporate more of the Bambis, and they're literally in the chapter of Bambietta's fight with Komamura, and Shinji's unhurt, and it seems that they've moved things around where Iba's now involved in a fight and Momo's involved in a fight, and I can envision what's happening. So while my initial reaction here is that either Shinji is fighting first and then it's going to be Komamura, or as Komamura is fighting, which I doubt, or they're far away, then that's when Shinji gets involved. But it's very apparent to me that, you know, with Shinji being unharmed, that fight never, not to say that it's not canon, it's just rearranged a little bit. And that's what I'm going to see. We're going to see some interesting interactions with the Bambis fighting against each other potentially. And Shinji's going to be using that Bankai, and it's going to be potentially really fascinating. And why do I say this? Or how do I think that this is ultimately going to go down? First and foremost, I think it's going to be Shinji and Momo at first. They're going to be fighting a bunch of Soldats. Now, I must say before I carry on, the PVs are like Marvel. They're very misleading. If you want to go watch the original PV for Core 1, a lot of the voice lines are not used the same way that they were in the show. So the Bankai kind of footage that we see from Shinji might not even be towards the soldats at all. He could have actually have just bodied them all at once, right? And this could have been towards the Bambis and he's talking directly to them. But because of the trailer, it looks like he's using them against the soldats. And it would make sense, right? Because obviously his Bankai is known for it. It's useful for it. But do you think really Shinji's going to have a problem with a bunch of foot soldiers? I personally wouldn't say so, unless it's for flex and effect, naturally. But personally, I think he bodies them. And I believe that Bambietta and the Bambis came with a bunch of foot soldiers. They kind of split up. Bambietta's going around. The foot soldiers are probably with the Bambi girls. And that's where, like, Momo's trying to fight or probably, like, fight some of the foot soldiers along with Shinji. And, you know, Komamura then comes in with Iba, and then Iba's fighting a bunch of the foot soldiers while Komamura is fighting Bambietta. And that's how I kind of see things going off, because they have to stay close to each other. So if Iba's fighting a bunch of soldats, then clearly he's going to have his help. He's going to be helping Momo, potentially, while Shinji is most likely kind of far away while this is all happening. He has to be, right? And considering the buildings, it would seem that maybe this is after Bambietta gets defeated, because the buildings are really damaged. And I really looked at, like, the manga panels to see what the damage of effect was. And when you look at Komamura's Bankai as well, most of the buildings are in tatters anyway. So it seems to me that this is mid-Komamura fight or after Komamura fight. I don't think it's before. So it's very interesting how the rearranging has worked here. Now, honestly, granted, does this change the final outcome of things? If there's going to be rearrangements and Shinji's not going to be there with Bambietta, and maybe he might use his Shikai on her, and maybe she'll be dazed. Maybe that's plausible too. Maybe, you know, that stays the same, but some contexts are different. Like Momo is fighting some soldats while Shinji and Komamura are dealing with Bambietta. That's absolutely the case. Maybe Bambietta doesn't get the hit on Shinji, and maybe he goes somewhere else to deal with the Bambietta group because maybe they interrupt. Again, that's a plausible possibility too, and probably the more likely one that would honestly maybe prefer. But does this change with Bambietta and the quote-unquote, I hate to say it, zombie form, right? Because obviously, if Shinji isn't damaged in the PV, then are the Bambietta girls or the Bambis going to be damaged when they confront Bambietta when she's on the floor close to death? And that's important because if Shinji is going to be using his Bankai on the Bambis, of course they're going to attack each other, and of course there is going to be some battle damage. So in this case, we really can't really rely on the manga to kind of speculate on this case. It really is a blind speculation on what the possibility is, because that scene could actually happen. Just most of them are battle damaged or like ripped clothes, or there's some blood on the face. That could be the possibility, and Shinji's ran away because obviously something didn't go quite right. That could be a possibility too. Or maybe the Bambietta scene just doesn't happen at all until maybe much later. A lot can be changed, and we know that a lot is going to change within all this. We're not going to talk about the sex scene. I'll make that into a separate video, or maybe the analysis. But yeah, Shinji versus the Bambietta girls. That's kind of really all I wanted to talk about this video. Do you believe in what I believe? What scenario do you think that this could in fact work? Do you like this scenario more? And do you really think that Shinji's Bankai is really only going to be shown for a few foot soldiers that he could probably solo? Granted, like, even put on the hollow mask, you know, even though for some reason they won't do that. Maybe there's, like, you know, a code or an unwritten, unspoken rule of to not wear the hollow masks. I haven't really looked into it. Maybe that's a video in and of itself of why Shinji doesn't choose to do that. But he could. Ultimately, he could. He doesn't really need to go Bankai. And Shinji to use his Bankai is really, ultimately, a last resort, right? It has to be a last resort. Anyways, he just can just do Hollow Mask and just, you know, do that without putting really anyone in danger in his surrounding vicinity. So it must be more than just soldiers. That's going to be the fun of the Thousand Year Blood War Arc Core 2, is that there's going to be a lot of original content. And I, for one, this is what I miss of Bleach. I have read the Thousand Year Blood War Arc, I've read Bleach so many times that everything to me is kind of obvious and normal to me, that, like, I just, when I see something like this, my brain gets ticking and I become overly obsessed with it, and it gets very exciting for me to talk about something speculative for once, and it brings me back to those chapter days. So yeah, tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below. I'm gonna stop waffling. With that being said, like and subscribe, of course, share this theory around. I want to hear more of what you guys think, and I'm gonna catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fun, David Hansen, as always, people. Peace out.